Welcome to our channel, Gaming Duology.
Hello, fellow gamers. Do you like opening loot crates that you didn't have to pay for and still getting the items? Well, New World has you covered. There are lots of different types of crates and containers that you can open and get multiple different sets of items from without having to pay for them. In this video, we're going to cover the supply containers and the ancient containers, where you can find them and what's in them. There's also a third type of container, which are provision containers that give you mostly foods and recipes, but we're not going to cover this in this video. Supply containers have crafting materials, furnishings, weapons, ammunition, and food in them. The supply containers come in three different sizes or tiers, if you will. The supply cache, which is your smallest container, the supply crate, which is your second largest container, and the supply stockpile, which by the name is your largest container. The ancient containers also follow this pattern. The smallest container is the ancient urn, the medium container is the ancient coffer, and the ancient chest is the largest container. These containers all have arcana crafting items, normal crafting materials, and sometimes equipment such as weapons or armor in them. As always, you can use the newworldmap.com in the description below to find where exactly all of these containers spawn. You just have to go under chests and click whichever supply or ancient container or provision crate you're interested in, and it will pop right up. And as you can see, there are a lot of them everywhere on the map. Using the time we had in the open beta, we went through a lot of the ancient containers and the supply containers to collect data on what they're most likely to spawn. We've compiled this data and we'll go over it now. The most common item we found was crossweave, which is a tier 3 crafting item. It spawns in all types of containers that we opened, but you have the highest spawn rate in the ancient chest and the supply stockpile. Now, if you're looking for solvents to do your leather crafting, you're better off looking for the supply caches, supply crates, ancient urns, and ancient coffers. So the smaller containers with the highest spawn chances. It's about a 20 to 25% chance to find the weak solvent in caches and urns. If you're looking to level up your woodworking skill, you'll need lots of the sandpaper. Coarse sandpaper is a tier 3 item that you'll need, and it is most commonly found in supply crates. You have about a 65% spawn chance of finding coarse sandpaper in these containers. Another tier 3 resource you'll need for crafting is sand flux, which we were able to find in supply caches and ancient coffers, with ancient coffers having a spawn chance of 60% that you will find some number of sand flux in it. Tannin, another tier 3 resource, can be found in almost all of these containers. The ancient urn has the highest spawn rate with about 46%, the ancient coffer is right behind it, and the supply crate and supply stockpile are roughly at 32% for this resource. As for food items, we only found a single food item, which was milk, and it was in a supply crate. Now to the more exciting news. If you're looking for some iron arrows or ammunition early on, supply crates and ancient coffers are your best bet to find these. Now, if you're looking to find weapons that are better than the ones that you can currently craft, which is very possible early game, you should look into ancient chests and supply stockpiles, as these have a high spawn rate of weapons. We were able to find a longsword of the ranger, which gives you 5 to 10 dexterity, a round shield of the soldier, which gives you 15 to 25 strength, and the great axe of the druid, which gives you 4 to 6 intelligence and 6 to 9 constitution. As you see, these weapons already come with perks on them, which makes them just slightly better than what you can craft. Of course, you'll need some armor to go with those better weapons. You'll find the most armor pieces in ancient chests and supply stockpiles. We were able to find the musketeer pants of Brigand, the pirate gunslinger gloves, embossed shoes, and conviviality shoes, all of which have special perks. Speaking of perk items, of course these containers also spawn items that you can use to put perks on your own weapons and armor as you craft them. The supply crate has the highest chance of spawning perk items with just over 16%, with the ancient urn being right behind it. We were able to find linen arcane embroidery, which gives you intelligence, 2 iron battle medals, which give you strength, 2 iron guardsmen's insignias, which gives you constitution. Now, if you've seen our recent video about perks and charms, you may be wondering where you find these. Well, Ancient containers and supply caches is a good start to find charms. Ancient urns have a 23% chance of spawning a charm, and ancient coffers have a 20% chance of spawning charms. We were able to find Orichalcum Great Axe charms, which helps you if you're using the Great Axe, Steel Lumberjack's charm, which gives you more XP while logging, Orichalcum Sword's charm, which helps you if you're using the longsword, Orichalcum Fire Staff's charm, which is great for when you're using the fireball attack on the fire staff, and the Jagged Horn, which gives you mortal energy. And lastly, we have an honorable mention of finding one glowworm bait in a supply crate. I hope this video helps you find these crafting items faster, or maybe even helps you find a better sword, better shield, whatever you're looking for in the game at the time.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget that notification icon to get all of our future videos.
We will be going over more resources as time goes on, so please like and subscribe and follow us on Twitch in the description below.
We'll see you guys later.
Tschüss!